God save.
Amen.
All right.
He's God save.
Amen.
But Luke 16 chapter.
19 verse.
From the 19 verse, 19 through the 24.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, I'm gonna like the beginning to wrap my reading. I'm gonna tell you the subject, the topic of it. There was a rich man which was clothed in purple and fine linen and fair sumpter. Yes. You know what that means? Something is if he was a Hebrew, they wrote the name every day. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, was laid at his gate full of sores and designed to be fed with the crumb which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. And it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angel to Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried. In hell, he lifted up his eyes, being tormented in Abraham for all, and Lazarus in his bosom. And he cried, said, Father, Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue. For I am tormented in flame, that means fire. But Abraham said, Son, remember that thou is in lifetime receive the good thing, and likewise mine the evil things, but now is comfort, and thou is in tormented. And for my subject tonight, today, this morning, on the other side. On the other side. On this side, you might be living very well. Don't want to share your goods with nobody. Want to take everything you want. You want to keep it to yourself. No one that you can share it with somebody. Okay, here we go again now. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid at the gate for the floor. So you know he must have been in bad shape for the dogs to come and lick him. He had to be in serious shape. He was messed up. Amen.
Yeah.
And desired to be fed with the crumb which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dog came and licked his sore, and it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angel Abraham's bosom, and the rich man also died and was buried. Just give me a little time, Pastor. In hell, he lifted up his eyes, being tormented, seeing Abraham fall, lying in his bosom. See, Lazarus was lying in his Abraham's bosom. But he cried and said, Father, Abraham, have mercy on me and send Lazarus that he may dip the tip off his finger in his water and cool my tongue. See, when you get on the other side, leaving all these material things behind, money, gold, clothes, hatred, murder, prostitute, gain, when it's going with wins. Men's marry men, and women's marry women. But when you get on the other side, you're not gonna go to heaven. You're gonna be down here, tall back in hell. Praise the Lord. That's a bad thing to fall into the hand of an angry God. What does it profit for a man to gain all this stuff and then lose your soul in hell? Hell is a place I don't even want my dog to go to. Because somebody, when you go to hell, ain't no dipping. You might tell your brother, dip, and cool my tongue. It's a little too late for that. You got a better chance to tell him to cool the dip now. Because you can live on the other side. Everything is these brother and sister. You know your sister and brother got to need some food, and you won't keep it all to yourself. But see, I got to think about my husband. I got to think about my children. I got to think about, don't think about Jesus.
That's right.
God, two loaves of bread, two fishes and five loaves of bread and fed 5,000. Now, if Jesus can do that, why we can't give each one of us a slice of bread? If my brother hungry, I'm going to feed him. I don't want to be like that old low-down, dirty, rich man. He was no good. He was no good with Bible. God told you to remember the things that you used to do to me, and now you're calling on me to dip the tip of my finger into some water and cool your tongue. You better ask good God to cool me while you're here. Because get to hell, ain't no cooling at all. I don't care who you see up there. Nobody up there in heaven will cool your tongue. But Jesus, you're going to walk around heaven all day knowing that we got God, that we got to go. We must fear God. What's wrong with us today? We don't fear him. Just because he ain't doing nothing don't mean I don't fear God. He loved me just as much as he loved that sinner. Of course, God loves you. Yes, he did. But he gave you an opportunity to change your life. If don't nobody want to go to hell like the rich man, he had everything. And poor brother Elijah laying at the gate, designed to get the crumbs that fall from the table. Falling from the table, crumbs. So, brother Elijah, we got to carry in the bosom of paper. And when we leave here, hallelujah. When we leave here, you don't have to worry about sickness. You don't have to worry about death. You don't have to worry about being hungry in heaven. You don't have to worry about crying in heaven. You don't have to worry about none of those things because God got it all. He got everything up there for us. But it's your desire. It's your desire that you want to go to heaven this morning. Or you won't say or speak through your ear. Don't listen to that preacher. She don't know what she's talking about. I would say it, God said it.
Right.
You get mad at anybody, get mad at God. He the one spoke these words, not me. So I'm just so excited about it.
Yeah.
I preached to some young people last night. They was excited.
Yeah.
Right. They was excited about the Lord. Mm-hmm. Because they ain't getting taught by the Lord now and then. All my man is trouble. So much trouble. But I want you all young people to know, when your mom and dad said something to you, be quiet. What were they right or wrong? Just shut up. When I tell you, don't go out that door. Mama, you can't tell me what to do. I'm going to run out there and get a bullet in your back. Because Jesus said in his word, a disobedient child will not live half long in their day. You got to honor your elders. I don't mean that's your mama. I don't mean that's your dad. Any of these elders in here, you better have enough sense to say yes, ma'am, and no, ma'am. That's the way I was brought up. No kid said nah, yes, no. But that old woman taught me something. I got to do. When she said, Bertha, get out of here. It's old people in here. I didn't move. She said, I'll tell you again to get out. And when that old lady looked back, that lick said, hey, you got to get that old lady. Sure, daddy's love this little girl. He loved this little girl. Mommy's love that little girl. But also Jesus loved this little girl. He wants you to be obedient to his word. You got a chance to repent. He said, repent for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. God is standing up here looking at you right now, saying, come to me.
Come to me
while the blood is running through your veins. Don't let that low-down, dirty devil tell you don't come and accept Christ because he want to get you in hell with him. Don't let him do it to you. You tell Satan, get behind me. I'm going to heaven. Who I want to go to heaven this morning? Kill you. He can't kill you. He might shoot you. He's able to destroy. destroy the body. But God is able to destroy them body and soul.
Yes, right.
He has destroyed both of them. So who tells Satan, get behind you, young people? God loves y'all. You're too pretty. You're too beautiful to be wasting this low life the world. You're too beautiful to be wasted by a low life demand. That old devil come around and kill you, beat up on your children, cuss you out. Ask God for a holy name. He got it for you, not so. But you got to wait on it. Because if you don't wait on it, you is not going to get it. Think about it. Listen what the Spirit is saying. Listen. You got to hear. Listen what the Spirit is saying to you. Praise the Lord.